From heavy snow in Virginia to gale-lashed rains in New England, the Atlantic seaboard reeled from one of the worst storms ever to hit the area. In the south, up to 3 feet of snow was dumped in some sections, and in Virginia, some areas were blanketed with their first snowfall in decades. Entire towns were isolated until equipment could be brought in to clear roads. Food and fuel were in short supply, bringing hardship to thousands. New York City girded for 6 to 8 inches of snow, but a scant half inch fell. However, gale winds ranging up to 60 miles an hour whipped the harbor and rivers and drove high tides into waterfront streets. Damage in New York City alone has been put at $20 million, most of it outside of Manhattan itself. On Long Island, authorities called the damage worse than any caused by hurricanes. A state of emergency was declared in Southampton and on Fire Island, where 35 homes were washed into the ocean. Before heading out to sea, the storm lashed hard and long at the Massachusetts coast. Here, too, gale-force winds drove waters far inland to collapse homes thought safe from the waves. The sea pushed in from Boston docks and wharves to flood streets in the shadow of the customs house. Of all the states along the Atlantic seaboard, New Jersey was the hardest hit. Asbury Park appeared as if some giant fist had pounded at it for hours on end. Thousands had to be evacuated from the coastal areas, and entire towns were declared off limits until health precautions could be taken. Most of the devastated shore towns, like Atlantic City here, have been declared disaster areas, making them eligible for federal aid to rebuild. A rough estimate puts the damage in Atlantic City alone at $30 million, with another $20 million in property loss along the rest of the New Jersey shore. It was one of the most costly storms ever to hit the eastern coast.